Oh, you caught me playing with my little chicken pincushion here. Isn't it cute? It's kind of big, huh? A little bit bigger than I anticipated. It's more like a little softy, isn't it? Okay, so this little guy, I saw a tutorial on Missouri Star Quilt Company's YouTube channel about making chicken pincushions. So her suggestion was to take any extra blocks you may have left over from a project. Make sure you have two of them. Make sure they're the same size. You might have to square them up a little bit to make sure they're the same size. And then you create this little pin cushion, and she has a very good tutorial there. So if you haven't seen it yet, check it out. Make yourself a little guy too, a little helper in your studio. But when I wanted to do it, I didn't have any spare blocks left over, probably because I have more UFOs than anything else, and I haven't got them finished to have any extra blocks left over. But I thought I would take some charm squares because, you know, that should work really simple. So what I did is I picked up a charm pack. This is Mama Said So by Sweetwater from Oda. And I just put four of them together. So I created, you know, you put four together, create one little block. Actually, I have something underneath here that's not going to work so well. So I stitched four together. That made my one block. And then I made another block, of course, squared them up. That wasn't too hard. They were pretty much the same size already. And then I continued on following Jenny's great instructions to make the little chicken. And he turned out, you know, I thought he'd be about this big, a chick, but he's a big rooster, this guy. So she shows you how to make the beak on it, the little fringe on the back here too. And for mine, I had these little buttons. I thought they'd be perfect for his eyes. So I actually stitched those on. I think Jenny tells you to, in hers, she just put on some pins with little black heads on them. So she just put those in for his eyes. But because mine was so large, I could get away with adding some buttons, which would have totally overwhelmed the smaller size one that she was making. So if you haven't checked out her tutorial on how to make a little chicken pin cushion, go ahead and do that. If you've got some extra blocks left over from a project, you can use those. Or maybe you've got some charm packs at home. And if you make them with charm packs, he's going to end up being this big. Okay, go make your little chicken and have fun with them in your studio.